Good afternoon, everyone. I welcome you to the session from Week Team Greater Noida. Today, I am going to talk about GDP, that is Gross Domestic Product. So let's start. Gross Domestic Product, that is GDP, is the monetary value of all finished goods and services made within a country during a specific period. What does this mean? This means that whatever an economy or a country produces during a particular year, the final value of all the goods and services is termed as GDP. Next point. GDP provides an economic snapshot of a country used to estimate the size of an economy and growth rate. So in order to measure the size of an economy as well as the growth rate of an economy, that is how an economy is progressing step by step, GDP is accurately used. Moving on to the next point. GDP can be calculated in three ways. So there are basically three measures by which we can calculate GDP. Let's move on to those three. The first one is expenditure method. The second one is value addition method or production method. And the third one is income method. It can be adjusted for inflation and population to provide deeper insights. So in order to check the growing population of a particular economy or country, these three methods are being used. The next point is, though it has limitations, GDP is a key tool to guide policymakers, investors, and businesses in strategic decision making. So there are several businessmen, right? So that the businessmen can take proper decisions for their effective functioning or running of their business, GDP plays an important role. Next one, the calculation of a country's GDP encompasses all private and public consumption, government outlays, investments, additions to private inventories, paid in construction cost, and the foreign balance of trade. So these are the different components or categories that GDP includes. So while we are calculating GDP, all these things has to be taken into account. What are they? Private and public consumption. This is the first one. Second one is government outlays. Outlays means whatever expenditure the government is doing. That also has to be taken into account during the calculation of GDP. Third one is investments. Fourth one is additions to public inventories. Fifth is paid in construction cost. That is whatever construction costs are being made, that also has to be taken into consideration. And the last one is foreign balance of trade. I repeat, it's not balance of payment, but balance of trade. The next point is the GDP growth rate compares 1 year or quarter of a country's GDP to the previous year or quarter. So while calculating GDP, how an economy or a country is progressing in a particular year, say for example in 2020, how India is progressing step by step. So we have to compare the GDP of the previous year, that is 2019, in order to measure how fast an economy is growing, just as I said just now. Usually expressed as a percent rate, this measure is popular for economy policy makers because GDP growth is thought to be closely connected to key policy targets such as inflation and unemployment rates. So in order to check the growing inflation as well as the prevailing unemployment in a particular economy or country, GDP is widely used. Now there are certain criticisms or limitations of GDP. Let's move on to those one after the other. The first one is, it ignores the value of informal or unrecorded economic activity. So whatever informal or unrecorded economic activity is taking place in a particular country, that is being ignored by GDP. GDP relies on recorded transactions and official data. So it does not take into account the extent of informal economic activity. What are they? Such as unremunerated volunteering, black market activity, underground activity, whatever takes place, all this are not recorded by GDP. The next one, it ignores business to business activity. GDP considers only final goods production and new capital investment and deliberately nets out intermediate spending and transactions between businesses. So in a nutshell, we can say that even though there are certain limitations of GDP, still it plays an effective role for the proper and effective functioning of an economy. So today I stop till here. We'll come back again with the next video from Week Team Greater Noida. Thank you very much.